Okay, welcome on NeeTV. In this video, I will show you another animation, simple basics. So open iClone 7 and make some props, some paysage, some landscaping. And we're gonna make walking lire just between those rocks. So for this, the first thing we need to do is to create a path. So go to create path, just before put your camera little up like this, go to create path and choose the first point. So the first point is right here and move to the second point. Now I'm gonna turn here. I'm gonna move right over here, right here, this one here. And I'm gonna come back just right here. And this is the end of the path. So I right click on it and I got my path. Okay, you can see the line right here. This is the path line. I'm gonna just adjust this one if I can. No, it seems nice. Okay, I'm gonna keep this. Maybe I can add in modify, I can edit a point here and select this one and move it right here. Let's check. Okay, you can change the angle. Wait, just right here with rotation. Not this one. I want to move this one like this. Okay, seems nice. Just want to move it with that key. Okay, so I'm gonna keep this. And now we're gonna use a character. So click on a character. So she's coming. She's right here. Now we're gonna put some clothes on her. So she needs boots. She needs forearm armor and chest plate. We just made in another video. So click on your character, zoom in. Now we're gonna put our character on the path. So I'm on my character and go to modify. And I choose path, pick path, and select the path right here. Now I'm gonna choose the orientation. So I click on follow path, Y axis. This is not the good path. I want the opposite side. So this is negative Y and it's done. Now we need to select an animation. So I'm on my character, go here inside animation, motion puppet, and we're gonna make a simple walk. So I go on move and go on thermal basic walk, press preview and press zoom on your character like this, press preview and press space key to see how it works. Okay, it seems nice. So I'm gonna use this one, this simple animation. But before, we need to go inside right here. We need to change the timeline. So I put the timeline right here to 20 seconds. So let's go to activate motion. We are on character, go in modify attributes right here. So this is the start of the path and this is the end. This is 0 and this is 100. Okay, so I take my timeline, I go to the end right here at 20 seconds, like here. Okay, and at 20 seconds I want my character at the end of the path. So 100%. Go back to the start and watch. the first thing we need to watch is the speed of the walk. So I think it's a little too fast for a simple speed. So we need to reduce the speed. So for reducing the speed, it's simple. Pause, start, select our character, go to animation, remove object animation. Now we need to adjust the timeline. So 20 seconds, it's too fast. So I go back to maybe 15 seconds more. So let's go to, we go back to the maximum. So if we can go back to the 50, because the standard, the default size is 30 seconds, but I just want 35 seconds or same 1 minute. How can I do? Just click here inside the project setting like this, and you need to change the total frame. Okay, so the total frame is right here, and 30 seconds, it's 1800. So we need to double it to get 1 full minute. So double it, it's simple. 8 plus 8, it's 16. So it's 16, 600. Okay, 1 and 1, it's 2. So 2. 2600 seconds, and that's it. And now I go to the end. And if I go to the end, I got, oops, sorry, I forgot something. I forgot this is 3, 3, 6, 3, 6. Okay. And now I got my 1 full minute. Okay, I got my 1 full minute. So I am on my character, go back to here, attributes, 1 full minute, but I think maybe 35 seconds is enough. So I go to 35 seconds, okay. Now I'm on my character, I select the path, pick path here, okay, and I want it to 100% when I am at 35 seconds. So I take the green arrow right here to stop the video at 35 seconds. Start and play. And it don't work. Why? Sorry. Pick path. This one. And when I am just right here. Oh, it's good. So play and she move. Okay, so I think for this walk it's good. Okay, let's play completely. Okay. Okay, seems nice. She make 35 seconds to go to the start point to the end point. And this is enough. Okay, so go back to the start. Select your character. Don't forget to click on follow path. Remember, this is the negative Y. Okay, and now we're gonna make animation. Go back into animation, go back to motion puppet, and we just select the basic move, female basics. And we're gonna push preview first, space key. Okay, she's moving. I think the synchronization of the beginning is not good, but for the next seems nice. So I'm gonna keep it. So I stop the animation with space key. And now I'm gonna push the record right here, and I'm gonna push the space key to record it. I don't need to do anything because it stopped at the green arrow. So push space key and let iClone do. So we need to wait. It's coming right here to the end. We are just watching for the moment. Just after, we're going to make the same with the following camera, like a third person game. So she's moving. Okay, no problem. We are near to the end, and this is the end, and that's it. Okay, stop. This is recorded. After, you can change the size. So maybe right here, as you can see, stop. Okay, she come here, and stop. Just right here, stop at 32 seconds exactly. So I put my green arrow like this to 32 seconds. And the movie stop right here. Now I go back to the start. And remember, the start, she don't move until a certain point. So push space key. She don't move. Stop. She's moving right here. So I push this the left arrow. Just right here. To the start of the good move. Go back to the start and play. And okay, that's perfect. Now we're going to make the same for the camera. So for this, we're going to choose just save your project. This is animation demo. No, the animation demo is already on the other video. So this is animation 2. No, this is walk. Sorry. Walking. Animation demo and save it. Okay, so now we're gonna make the same for the camera. So I take my path. If you can select your path, you can go into scene, select the path right here. And what we need to do is to right click on it, and you need to. Okay, I don't think it works. Edit, you need to copy it. It don't want to be copied, so you can use the W key. You can push, keep pushing the control key and move up with the blue to create the exactly copy of the original one, path 0. Okay, go back to modify. And move your camera, okay. And what we need to do right now is simply go near, right here, go back into create camera, okay. Name your camera as follow cam, like this. Now move, you are on follow cam, so move right over here, okay. And go back to right here to preview cam. This is the preview cam. This is the follow cam. Okay. So follow cam is selected. Now go inside the menu right here and select path. Select this path right here. Okay. So now what we need to do, it's simply just follow the character. So you move, we move. At the end, the character is right here. So we are on this. We are on the follow cam, and I put the path position. I follow the cam like this, and I stop just right here before the character. Right here. Okay, now I go to click on follow path, follow the invert in a negative Y, like exactly is not working. Okay, this is not the negative Y, this is the Y. No, this is the X. Let me show. Is this the X? No, the X negative, not this one. For this one seems to be the X. Okay, maybe this is the X. And I go back to the start. I think this is this one. And I go to look at pick target and look at the character. Okay, let's play. The camera is focused on the character and is following the path. Seems pretty good. Okay, stop. Go back to the start. Change the preview, go back on follow cam and push play. Do not move and just push play. Okay, we need to be more. Just push play again with spacebar. Go back to the start. Do not touch the camera. And we need to change the size. So 20 millimeters. 20 millimeters seems good. Angle of view more like this. Okay. No play. And we are following our character. So let's go to the beginning, to the end. The size is nice. Okay. If you want the height of the camera more up, you just need to move the second path more up. Okay? Because it's fixed to the path. And now we stop. And that's it. We made a follow cam. Okay, it's perfect. Go back to here, preview cam. Like this. Let me show you. If you are in follow cam, do not move your camera because you are moving the animation, okay? So, just use the preview cam to move. Okay, I think all is good, and now we're gonna make a render. So, go back to the start. Okay. Maybe we can add some special things. Special things like why? Let me know. We're gonna keep this. Okay. So we're gonna make a render. So for the render, I choose I save my work before. So for the render video, I just choose the follow cam. Okay. I go to render and I go to render video. I choosing my format. This is a video MP4 for YouTube. Okay. The frame by second 30. That's enough for YouTube. 1080p, okay. You can change it right here. If you get sound, but I don't have sound. 360 panorama, but I don't have it. Final render, super sampling, zoom size, height 3x3, height quality DOF. And we can make a visual. Here in visual, we can make HDR effect and tone maps. To get something more darker and more nice. Maybe we can change the exposure. Something like this. Okay. And we can show the sky if we want. No, we're not gonna use the sky. We're just gonna keep this simple. I'm gonna make another video for HDR effect in another time. So I don't use HDR for this one. Okay, so now I go back to export range, not all, because all is 1 full minute, and the range we need is between this one and this one. So click on range. It starts from 188 and it finished to 1977. Okay, so it's good. So I'm gonna click on export. Right here, and let's go export. I choose walk animation like this and save.